Hello, folks. Come on in. Make yourself comfortable. My name is Alex, if you don't know already, and in this video, we're going to talk about some of the ways that you can record pitch bend maneuvers after you've recorded your MIDI data. Okay? All right, let's have a look. Okay, so while I was kind of surfing around online, lately I've been visiting the Bitwig site because I'm waiting for 2.1 to drop, and I've looked at the Q&A section, and a lot of people seem to have some confusion when it comes to recording pitch bend maneuvers after you've recorded your MIDI. So by that I mean, of course, while you're playing your MIDI like this, of course you can use your pitch bend wheel and get the effect there. But say, now that I've recorded my MIDI without using the pitch bend wheel, in this case, just a single C note there, a C3, what if I want to add pitch bend maneuvers to this note after the fact, right? Okay, so what I've done here is I've loaded up two tracks. One is just a polysynth, which is, as you know, a Bitwig default plugin. And the other one is Serum, but this could have been any of them. This could have been any synth that's not native to Bitwig, like Reactor 6, Massive, Contact, or Expand! Exclamation mark. I think it's actually pronounced EXPAND! Right? Because of the exclamation mark? Okay, never mind. So that's all I've done. Two tracks. On both tracks, it's just got a single MIDI note, which is a C. So now I would like to record pitch bend maneuvers on this. And you're thinking, well, that's easy. Hit record, press space, and let it rip. I'm moving it, I swear to you, and it's not doing anything. Well, that's strange. And also, I can tell you that no matter how you play with this, whatever you do, you can go in here and play with the touch and write features. Whatever you do, it's not going to show up. So that's strange, and we'll get into that in just a second here. But if I go over to Serum now, right, and I'll let you hear this. Yeah, real beautiful. It's a C3. And if I want to record automation on that now, let's try this again. I'll hit record, hit space. All right. So it made a difference. If you click in the automation lane, look, there pitch bend shows up, and there's my pitch bend. And now if I hit play, of course, that works. So that's easy enough. That worked out. So why didn't it work with the Bitwig plugin, right? Because this is simple. This is acting just like it should in any other DAW, and that's fine. And we don't even really need to talk about that any further because it's that easy. But for some reason, the polysynth, it is not having that effect. And, okay, so if you haven't noticed yet, when I hit the polysynth, you'll notice over here, there's a check mark beside convert pitch bend, okay? And if I click Serum, it's turned off. I didn't turn this off. Bitwig's default, when you load in an exterior VST like this, is to turn that off. And so, what does that exactly mean, you're wondering? Well, with Serum, this doesn't need to be on. And I'll tell you, it's because Serum already recognizes this as the pitch bend wheel. See, I'm moving the wheel on my keyboard, and you can see it clearly going up and down here. So it's got a built-in pitch bend function in it that's auto-mapped to my MIDI keyboard. Okay? Well, with Polysynth, that's not the case. You would think it would be mapped to here, but look, I'm moving the wheel and nothing's happening. And no matter where you look on here or where you search through all of this stuff, you're just not gonna find it. For example, I could go to pitch bend, but it's not gonna be in there, right? So what's happening when they convert to pitch bend? What they really mean is, if I double click on this, okay, I'm gonna delete this note. And I'm gonna bring up, I'm gonna click this. This is the micro pitch expressions page, okay? So I'm gonna turn off velocity and click this, okay? So now when I record the same note and I modulate the pitch bend wheel, watch what happens, okay? I'm gonna mute that guy. So what do you see? Well, here's my pitch bend expression, and it's found inside the micro expressions. And that's kind of interesting because now it's not anywhere in my automation lane. I could search, look at, I'm on pitch bend because I went and clicked this, and it's not there. But we're getting the effect, it's just in here. It's so effectively, when this is clicked, what it's doing, it's telling it that the whatever is mapped to your pitch bend wheel on your keyboard, forget about it and remap it over to this micro expressions thing. And this can have its benefits for sure, because it's a super, I really like that it has this micro expressions things, because now I can, just like with automation, I can add in pitch bends to any synth ever, okay? And anything that's in MIDI. And it's as simple as doing that. And it's nice because it's right on top of the notes as well. It's not in an automation lane. And because it's on top of the notes, you can see exactly how many notes and semitones it is away. Like this one, now I can tell that that's on, what is that? B flat, isn't it? Yeah, a B flat. And that's perfect. So if I want to pitch bend it to an exact amount, I can use this guy, and that's a super handy feature. The only real issue is that now when I want to record it in after the fact, if I didn't have this here, I would not be able to record my pitch bend after the fact. Not like with Serum, where I just hit record and I just move my pitch bend wheel and bada bing, it's all done. So, a little bit strange, isn't it? Well, there is a workaround to this, and I'll show it to you now. So here's my polysynth, and I'm gonna click the mod button there, click plus, and add in MIDI, and I think you know where I'm going with this right now. I'm gonna click over and choose bend, okay? I'm gonna click the mod button, go over to pitch, and just move it up a bit, just however much, whatever I feel like is necessary. And so now what you also have to do is turn this off, right? Because remember, having this on makes it so that it unmaps whatever you want it to, like it unmaps your MIDI keyboard's pitch bend wheel and auto maps it to that lane in here, right? And again, to get there, you click this, right? And then that line shows up. So you have to turn that off. And now, if you see, when I move my pitch bend wheel, you can see on the pitch that it's working. So let's see. Yeah, works like a charm. So now what if I want to record? All right, well, it seemed to have worked. Let's see, pitch bend, and there it is. Okay, so now it's behaving the same way as it is inside Serum, which is interesting. And the reason is because now it's on a feature inside the polysynth that can be automated, right? Okay, I know that's very confusing. The other thing that I noticed is, let me just undo some of this stuff here. You know, I'm just gonna delete that and start fresh. Go to synth, choose polysynth. There we go. I also noticed that it's not exactly a smooth sounding pitch bend with this convert pitch bend thing. It kind of clicks. Let's have a listen. See that? It kind of jumps. It sounds like it's clicking to semitones. Where if I listen to Serum for a second, let's mute that. It's very smooth. So that's an interesting difference as well. So it's just a couple things to consider. But I will say this. One thing I do love about this feature, aside from it being kind of annoying if I want to convert, or sorry, if I want to record pitch bends after my MIDI's already been recorded, I do love the feature because, again, you can just turn this on and then there's your note and there's the line, showing that right now this note is gonna play exactly that note the entire time. But if I wanted to, undo that, sorry. if I wanted to, I could add in some points and I could really play with it. And say I want it to wiggle by exactly a semitone where it's going from C to C sharp to B, okay? Go like this and go like that. And that's interesting because how would you accomplish that doing it the other way when it's just the pitch bend in the automation lane, right? Because it's all relative. So I guess 50%, if it was set at two semitones, would technically be one semitone, but that's just a whole slew of crap if you wanted to get an exact pitch bend. If you wanted a perfect pitch bend on a note, or if you wanted to bend this note down 12 semitones, an entire octave to meet another note, or say, for example, I had a note here, right? Let's just extend this a bit. Okay, and so say I want to glide this note down to there. Well, that's easy enough. I just have to drag this note and put it there. And see, now this note will glide gracefully onto the next one. You see that? And that would be very difficult to accomplish using the pitch bend wheel with Serum. You would have to, I mean, let's not forget though, you can still, let's just load up Serum again, sorry folks. You absolutely can go inside Serum and do the same thing, okay? This applies to any MIDI ever. So you can click this button on any kind of MIDI data and get that. You can get it on drums. It's especially cool on 808s, right? You can re-pitch your 808s to match the song chord changes, everything. Anything like that. And that's incredibly useful. It's just a bugger because now if I want to record it after the fact, I can't really do that unless I turn this off, go in here, add in the MIDI, right? Turn on the bend, map it over to pitch, choose how much I want it to pitch, and then test it out. Yeah, it's ready to go, and now record. So it's not that big of a deal. It's just a few more extra steps that are kind of unnecessary. It'd be nice if they worked it out so it worked automatically this way, and they kept the feature where you have this as well. Okay, all right, I hope that clears up a little bit of confusion for you guys. I just saw a lot of questions online about this, and I thought that I would make a quick video to help some of you guys out, because I know for me, when I first got Bitwig 2.0, this was super confusing. I didn't know what the hell was going on, and I'm used to recording my MIDI without the pitch bend, and then after the fact going and recording all the animation parameters after the fact, because that gives me the most control. I can wiggle the knob a little bit better. Unless I'm playing live, then that's the way I like to do it personally. Okay, and I just had I struggled hard with this for a little while until I kind of figured out why it was happening. I figured out how to do it, but now I hope you understand why it's happening and what convert pitch bend means. Okay, if you have any more questions, certainly shoot them down below. I'm happy to help you. That's what I'm here for. And that's, you know, that it makes me happy to help you, essentially. Okay, and I hope you subscribe. If you don't, well, have a good day anyway, and I hope you return at some point when you have another question, and then you can just ask old Alex here and I'll help you out. Okay, all right kids, ciao.